Hello friends, so today I'm going to teach you ground improvement technique. I'm going to discuss about two topics, need for ground improvement and different types of problematic soil. So I'm Chitra CJ taking you ground improvement. So let's see the need for ground improvement. Ground improvement techniques are used when the behavior of the fill mass or the underlying soil does not meet the required design criteria. That means that the soil as it exists may not be suitable for supporting a structure. So we have to alter the properties of the soil to increase its bearing capacity. So the ground improvement is carried out to prevent the excessive settlement of the surface. It improves the shear strength of the soil and it increases the density of the soil. And it improves the soil permeability to increase the drainage capacity. So these are the significance of ground improvement. So let's see the different types of problematic soil in detail. First is expansive soil. Expansive soil contains some minerals that are capable of absorbing water and it increases its volume. This increased volume causes additional force to the building and causes damage. Similarly, when it dries out, it shrinks dramatically and this shrinkage can remove support from the foundation and causes much more damage to the building. And the example is black cotton soil. In the figure, you can see that the cracks are formed when it dries out. Okay, now next is collapsible soil. As the name indicates, it collapses down when it is saturated. So when it is dry or unsaturated, it is able to withstand high pressure over it. But once it is wetted or saturated, it falls down and it causes damage to the building. So example is pure gravel. And next is soft soil. The water content of these types of soil is very high. So we need to alter the properties of the soil to reduce the water content. Example is marine clay. And in the figure, you can see that there's a sudden fall of soil of the pure gravel when it was suddenly saturated. Now, next is organic soil. The organic content of these types of soil is very high and it's having typically very low strength and the compressibility is very high. And next is char deposit. And these types of soils are formed by the soluble rock like limestone and gypsum. And they have very less density. So we have to alter the properties in order to construct a building over these types of soil. Solution and alternatives. Avoid a particular site having these problematic soil. Design the construction accordingly. So we have to decide whether we have to construct the flexible structure or the rigid structure over these types of soil. Or we can opt for the combination of these two. And we can also remove this unstable soil from the top layer and we can replace it with more stable soil. Next is to modify the existing ground. We can modify it or modify the properties of existing ground soil. Now next is enable cost-effective foundation design. So these are the alternatives that we can take when during the construction of the building over these types of soil. Thank you.